Tom Riddle's costumes, when you're watching him in the films, it will be school uniform, some sort of younger boy's suit. Now, you have to remember that Tom Riddle was actually an orphan. So a little bit like Harry Potter, you presume that maybe he doesn't own that many clothes. So he wears a lot of the same things. Whereas if you think of the Harry Potter films, Harry, Ron and Hermione are not in their uniform that much. Tom Riddle probably took a lot of pride in his uniform because it's probably the best thing he owned. And then you get Voldemort version of Tom Riddle, where he's now reborn in the Goblet of Fire film, and he couldn't be wearing something more different if he's tried. He's wearing wizarding robes, so it's almost like he's fully accepted that he is a wizard and he's going to be this dark lord that he's created. When Ralph Fiennes came in to talk about what he wanted for his character, they actually spoke about the elements of smoke, being a ghost. He can appear and disappear whenever he wants to. It was really important for his version of Voldemort that that was how he arrived to a scene. They also never finished the bottom of his costumes. You'd usually hem a costume when you finish it, and it adds weight to the bottom of the costume, which will drag it down. So they decided to leave it, and it's a raw hem on it, not something I think you can find anywhere else in the entire Harry Potter film. Not many people notice in the films that the robes are actually seven different shades of green. They help represent the seven Horcruxes, and they cleverly get rid of a shade of green as a Horcrux disappears. So his colours are fading. Voldemort doesn't wear shoes in the films. It's to do with the fact that he is reborn in the fourth film, and so he is fresh, he's new. His robes are meant to feel like a second layer of skin, so he doesn't wear shoes. But you'll notice he has really horrible nails, both on his toes and his hands. They're a bit outgrown, they're a bit long. He's very well put together as the Dark Lord, but then there's always the elements that are reminding you that he is an orphan, he hasn't been brought up maybe as well as some people. And so there's always going to be an element that brings him back down to life.